Second down, a little ways to go here. Second and 13. Again, it's Miller. And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. It goes as a loss of 6. And now third down.
Doesn't take any great analysis on my part. It's been pretty obvious. Last couple plays, this guy's been going in the wrong direction.
Offensive line overwhelmed on those plays. Now, I think it's safe to say going to the air here on third. Third and long. It's Savage. And on the left side, Flores has it. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a fourth down. I think defensively, you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that, and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series, they have to work hard to put their first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
They'll throw on first down with Wilson. Airing one deep for Curse. He's got a man complete. It's a big play there for Seattle. 51 yards. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there. To throw is Wilson. Flush to his right. Looking for the end zone. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
Well, you got a receiver here who's got one touchdown already in this first quarter, and they were trying to double his pleasure there. Ronnie continued to go to the guys, already got into the end zone. A good coverage to make sure that this time it fell incomplete.
And incomplete, almost intercepted. Had a great shot of picking that off in the end zone. And now fourth down.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield. But when push came to shove, they stood their ground. Now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
Now Wilson. And another run. And he is rattled. Knocked down hard at the 17-yard line. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
It's caught outright by Graham. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
I think it's okay though. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
On second down, Wilson. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. Jermaine Curse, a 14-yard touchdown. And the Seahawks are running away with this one.
You know, in golf, they often talk about playing the course and not worrying about what the other players are doing, what their scores are. That's essentially what we're seeing from this offense. They're just having fun and doing what they feel like doing today.
I just missed the 3-point conversion. Oh my gosh. Nah, bro. There's a flag. It's a flag on the play. I'm already winning. It's over.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yards.
Does it?
On first and 10, Savage. And he's got it. Fedorowicz. It'll be a gain of 4. And it's a second down. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works. ways for the Ravens team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop, you keep throwing it. Occasionally, you break the tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to creep up, start to push your receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
10 yards there, good enough for a Texan first down.
All right, I'm doing my rudimentary math here. That's his third catch here in the first quarter. I don't know if it's just game plan or he's just trying to play
it. Maybe a little of both.
Here's a give to Miller. And down to the 36-yard line here. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
And incomplete on the deep ball.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Fly into the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
They'll try to run for it with Miller. And he's going to go backward.
That's four plays blocked. They got to go for a kick.
After a loss of one.
Michael Bennett's versatility and being able to play any position along the defensive front allows him to make those types of plays. He has good
kick
matchup.
Blocked. Their kick blocked. I'm running home. Hey, guys.
Touchdown, Seahawks.
Touchdown.
We talk about it a lot, one of the dangers of the long field.
That's 40-0.
Oh,
41.
Makes it susceptible to a block here, not only
in the second quarter.
And how about how well they did on the return?
You got that kickback.
Oftentimes in that type of a scrambling situation, someone will clip, someone will block below the waist, right? You name it.